Good evening, everyone. We are so delighted to be able to be back in person to perform with you once again. This is the Academy Orchestra, and I'm Jim Setapen, the director of the Academy. We'd like to begin our program tonight with a charming work by the African-American composer William Grant Still, his Dances of Panama. What Mr. Still did is take a number of folk dances and folk songs from the rich heritage of the country of Panama and arrange them into a suite of four short movements. In the originals of these dances, a lot of them had drums and other percussion instruments. So what does he do? How is he going to make that effect? Well, he asks the string players to tap on their instruments. Sounds like this. And there you have the percussion of the Academy Orchestra. This music is sensuous, it's exciting, it's happy, and it's fun. We hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Some of the greatest composers never wrote anything for a string orchestra. Composers like Schumann, Chopin, and Brahms. When my colleague Cliff Colnott asked if he could arrange something for this orchestra, excuse us while we change, we try to give everybody in the orchestra a chance to sit in different places. Anyway, when Cliff Colnott asked me if he could arrange something for this group, I suggested that he try to find some music by one of these great composers, maybe a piano piece, and orchestrate it so the students would have the chance to get to know a little bit more of the music of one of these composers. And so here today you will hear the first performance of two late intermezzos by Johannes Brahms. This is the intimate Brahms. It's not the heroic grand Brahms of the symphonies or the concertos. The first one you're going to hear, there are two of them, begins with a beautiful melody here in the first violins. And then there is a darker middle section, and then that melody comes back in the first violins. It's very, very satisfying. The second intermezzo is slower, it's darker, it's more introspective, it's more dreamlike. Its ending is so tender and soft that you almost don't want to breathe. It's just a very exquisite moment. So here are the two intermezzi of Brahms. It's okay to applaud after the first one if you like it.
Thank you.
Do we need a name? You okay? Our next composer has an unusual name. His name is Ermanno Wolf Ferrari. Ermanno would be Herman in English. Herman's father was German and his name was Wolf, which means the same thing in both languages, although the Germans would pronounce it Wolf. And his mother was Italian, so he decided to hyphenate his name, Ermanno Wolf Ferrari. Herman was a composer prodigy. He wrote this four-movement serenade for strings when he was 17 years old. There are people on this stage older than 17 years old, not just me. This is music that shows his mastery of form, his mastery of harmony, his ability to write idiomatically for strings. But it's much more than that. This is really inspired music that has memorable tunes and an amazing variety of moods. There is a charming tune in the middle of the third movement, goes something like this. Don't worry, it sounds better when they play it, but you'll recognize it now. The second movement is my favorite movement. It begins with a really gorgeous melody, which he asks us to play with intimate feeling. There are also many passages in this piece that show off the virtuosity of these young players. Here is Ermanno Wolf Ferrari's Serenade for Strings.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. Many works by Dmitri Shostakovich are full of tragedy and Russian melancholy. The first piano concerto is mostly not like that. It's exuberant, it's humorous, sparkling, very high-spirited piece, and it changes mood practically from phrase to phrase. It's in four movements, lasts about 20, 25 minutes, and the movements are mostly played without pause. There may be a few seconds pause after the first movement, but basically it all goes together. The unusual thing about this particular concerto is that it has a big part for the trumpet, besides the usual strings and the piano soloist. The first movement is rather serious, but then it becomes sort of mercurial and, as I say, changes character from moment to moment. The second movement, slow movement, is a slow, sad Russian waltz that has a sort of furious middle section and then gradually seems to be exhausted by the end. The third movement is very short, less than 2 minutes, and it's a sort of interlude, but it's rather intense in the middle of it. And then the last movement is like we're at a circus. It's all high-spirited, it's very, very energetic. It has lots of nervous energy, which evidently Shostakovich himself personally did. He was constantly fidgeting and everything. And it ends with a blaze of glory with a trumpet fanfare. The solo piano part is extraordinarily difficult in this piece. It has runs that move as fast as you can run. It has leaps that go as fast as you can leap, or possibly faster than you can leap. The orchestra part is also very challenging. It's no joke, and these young players have risen to the occasion. Please welcome our soloists, pianist Winston Choi and trumpeter Matt Baker.
Mm-hmm.